What's up, Living Water?
Yeah. Welcome to Living Waters Church. Are you ready for worship? Woo!
Join in with me. Hey! This is the house of worship. Stand up on your feet. This is the house of worship. What they gonna do? Join in.
Keep on loving me,
loving me.
Oh, come on, take it.
Keep on.
social media. So we're going to follow Living Waters Church on all our social media pages. Okay, so on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, our page name is LWC Detroit. Again, that's LWC Detroit. Can I make some noise if you do it? Okay, thank you. And to add to our social media page, we virtually have Snapchat. Let me hear the youth with the Snapchat. Okay, now the page is LWC Detroit. Again, that's LWC Detroit. And also, you can check us out on our website at lwcdetroit.com. Let me hear you make some noise if you did it. Thank you. Okay, can also all of our visitors please raise your hands? We would like to thank you for coming. Thank you for coming, and our ushers will greet you. Okay, now let's get ready to kick off our first annual Splash Day number one.
Yeah!
Give it up for Madison Kearney, y'all. Everybody up, we got our theme song. Y'all know how we do this time. Yeah. Getting ready. Come on, little Jay Moss, hit it up. PDA, bring it up on the stage for us, baby. Somebody scream in here. A little bit more track in the monitors. Be 1, 2, 3, go.
Yo, everybody, welcome to Living Waters with God. Open his arms to all sons and daughters. And all sons and daughters, get up to pray the Father. Park your seat, get on your feet like it's no tomorrow. Let me tell you about the name of Jesus. He will take you away from evil, saving other people. Angels in heaven celebrating. So what you waiting for? Here's the open door. Get up and come on. 2.
It's in the air. Come on, y'all. Get him up. Get him up. Yeah, come on.
This is the place
that we go for.
That we go for.
And
Make some noise in this building one more time. One more time. Welcome to Youth Sunday at Living Waters Church. Don't our babies look good? Aren't they doing a good job? My wife and I, Pastor Mel, we vowed, we said we're going to make our young people feel like they have a chance to praise God their way. Now, come on, y'all. Y'all gonna have to make noise today.
Yeah.
I told you to dress comfortably. I told you to put your gym shoes on because we're gonna jump, scream, and holler with them all day long. Because we want them to feel like they can do it here instead of at Jay-Z's concert. Come on, somebody, make some noise in here. I want them to look forward to Splash Sunday number 2. Come on, little J-Bond, where my little prayer at? Where my little J? There he is. Come on, y'all, give him some love. J-Bond, Irv. You all right, man? Belinda, we're going to get him a microphone. Listen. I always like to highlight people when they do well. This young man is anointed. He's anointed. And for those of you who don't know, his name is Jay Bond, and he's our own Elder Joe's son. One day he was at school, and he was younger, and a mother dropped off her child, and the child was suffering from autism. Come on, everybody standing up. This is probably going to be one of those stand services. And the mother dropped off her child at the school. And the child was just screaming. The child was suffering from autism. He was autistic. Wouldn't talk. I don't know if he was necessarily a mute. Joe didn't give me that. But he definitely didn't talk. He didn't talk. He didn't interact with anybody. So he was crying and screaming. He was crying and screaming and crying and screaming. And they said, little Jay Bond walked up to the door, or whatever this entryway was where he could see the little young boy. And they were like, J-Bond, what are you doing? And he said, J-Bond was just kind of pointing the guy out, pointing him out, pointing him out. And since J-Bond's a good kid, he's got a great track record, they didn't think anything was wrong. So they said, Jay, if you want to go on in that classroom, you can go on in that classroom. The guy was just screaming. The little baby was just screaming, screaming, hollering, screaming, hollering. So J-Bond goes into the room. Watch this. All of a sudden, the little boy that was hollering and screaming stopped crying, and he was talking to J-Bond. Don't tell me what God can't do at a young age. Not only did he stop crying, he started talking. You don't know who God is going to use. That's why today we got to make some noise for our young people. That's why today there is still hope, because God has a calling on their life. He's going to pray with our young people. Come on, let's get behind him as he goes through the throne of grace.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come to you and say thank you, God. If we have sinned against you, we ask you for forgiveness, and thank you for forgiveness. We thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for bringing us together again in your house. We thank you that you come in this place in the name of Jesus. You said where two or three are gathered together in the name that you are here today. Set free and deliver, touch our pastor, and give him word to help us bless our families and schools.
Yeah.
Our neighborhoods, bless our parents, that no weapon formed against us will prosper. Rebuke the devil from this place. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. That ain't easy to do. That ain't easy to do. Come on, show him some love. That ain't easy to do. That's not easy to do. We thank God for Lil J-Bond. We thank God for Elder Joe being back from off the road. Come on, y'all. Make some noise. Elder Joe had a death in the family, so he had to go and take care of some family business. And when you leave and go on the road, and you let us know here at Living Waters, we cover you in prayer.
So we're glad that Elder Joe is back and in our midst. Amen. He's a vital asset to this ministry. Come on, y'all, make him feel good. Elder Joe, y'all think he's strong, and you heard his testimony and you heard what he said, and you know his street background. But he called me one day and he said, "Elder Jay, Pastor Jay, I need you to pray for me, man." He said, "This one down here is tough for me." And that's what we're here for. So when we tell you to pray and we tell you to look out for our brothers and sisters here at Living Waters, we really need it. Because you never know when somebody is at their weak point. So we have to stand in the gap and hold them up. Amen? Amen. Youth Sunday, I'm excited, y'all. I'm excited. Woo! Thank you, Lil' J-Bond. Get your playbooks out. Y'all know how we do. Get your playbooks out. My name is Pastor Jay, James L. Moss here at Living Waters Church. We welcome you. Thank you, Madison Kearney, for doing that. Did you all enjoy our praise team? Woo! Pastor P, who going to clean all this mess up back here? Who going to? Somebody got to clean. Somebody. Woo, I just love it. We're having such a good time. This is absolutely wonderful. You're getting your playbooks out, and we are going to, let me see. God done changed up all my script today. I was going one way, and he said, "No, we're going to take a right turn." Genesis 25, 31. Get your playbooks out, and we're going to Genesis 25 and 31. Since this is Youth Sunday, I am going to do most of my scriptures today out of the Message version. And now my older saints, my older Christians here and believers, just bear with us a little bit. Today we're going to make it plain and simple so that our young people can understand. This is their day. You want the deep stuff, I want you to come back next week, and then we're going to pick up right where we left off from last week. But right now, this one is for our babies. Amen? All right. We want you to be lively. We want you to be energetic so they can understand that this is all really cool stuff. Genesis 25, 31. James has it up on the screen. What does it say? Jacob said, "Make a trade. My stew for your rights as the firstborn." Jacob said, "Make a trade. I'll trade you my stew for your rights as the firstborn." Go to the next one, James. 32 says, Esau said, "I'm starving. What good is my birthright if I'm dead?" Go to the next one, James. Jacob said, "First, I need you to make it plain to me. I need you to swear to me." And he did it. On oath, Esau traded away his rights as the firstborn. Jacob gave him bread and stew, and he ate and drank, got up and left. Do I have another one up there, James? That's how Esau shrugged off the rights as his firstborn. As the firstborn. Yep, that's it. That's how Esau shrugged off his rights as the firstborn. Esau made a trade with his brother to give him the rights that he was due as the oldest brother. He traded it for a bowl of soup. Yeah, that's the response I was looking for. He traded his inheritance. Everything that God had in store for him, everything that was due him by law, by the laws of family, he traded it for a hamburger. I'm trying to make it plain. So I want to talk to you for just a few moments for our babies today. Don't lose your gift for being too thirsty. Don't lose your gift. Look at somebody and say, "Don't lose your gift for being too thirsty." Look at somebody else and say, "Don't lose your gift for being too thirsty." All right, we're going further. We're going. What is that?
Knock, knock.
What? PDA,
who's there? This thing on?
How yeah. Did you let this happen?
Anybody seen Jay?
Hello?
Oh, I see you down there, Jay. What's good, Jay?
Come on, man.
Oh, my bad. My bad. Pastor Jay, I see you doing your Pastor Thug.
James, how did you let this happen, man? Come on. You can't say that in church.
My bad.
Come on.
Hey, my name Hype B. Yes, Jay. Good. I'm 6 months straight out the pen, and I work down at the studio for pajama and I drive. jacked and everything.
Does anybody need to know that? We didn't ask you who you were.
I'm sorry. Well, you always told me to properly introduce myself when I'm around people, so I just was doing what you...
But that's too much information, man.
I'm sorry. Well, I heard that you said it was Thursday, so I brought you a drink.
No, my sermon title is being thirsty.
Oh, you want the syrup. You should have said syrup. Oh, okay, I got the Miss Butterworth. I got the maple cinnamon. I got the quicker pepper.
Habib, I said it's my sermon title. My sermon.
Oh, yeah, that's your sermon. Oh, I see. My bad, Jay.
Pastor Jay.
My bad. Pastor Jay, I see you doing your pastor thug. That's with my nizzle and everything.
Come on, man.
I see you, man. Well, okay. I know you, bitch. So I got one more question before you leave.
Get on with it.
I mean, I'm sorry, before I leave.
Yes, before you leave.
You already there. I'm sorry. Where you want me to put your drink?
Habib, get off my screen!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, y'all. Habib don't get out much, so he... Would y'all not let Habib invade the service no more? What? Thirsty! Somebody say thirsty. Habib thirsty up there, y'all. Habib is thirsty. The young people got a saying out here, you too thirsty. You out here looking thirsty, dog. That's how they say it. Yo, you out there, Ryan, you out here looking thirsty, yo. Thirsty, man. D-Dog, you up there playing them drums looking thirsty, yo. What does that mean? When you're thirsty, the Urban Dictionary defines it as too eager. You're too eager. You're looking desperate. Too eager and desperate. And on the street, thirsty kind of mean you're too eager to try to get some play. You know, you see a nice little young lady walking by, blah, 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 blah. You would never want to look too thirsty. You understand? You know, nice little female, you know what I'm saying? Y'all can look thirsty too. Them skirts be a little short. Little cleavage be out. Y'all can look thirsty too. Look at somebody and say, don't lose your gift. For out here being too thirsty. Yeah, the regular definition of thirsty is it's a sensation of the dryness of mouth. And it usually triggers a need for liquid. And another definition of thirsty in Webster is a strong or eager desire. Now, thirsty isn't all bad. It's a good thing when you're out exercising and you're doing your thing and you eat a good meal or something like that. Yes, you can become thirsty. You replenish. You're good. But thirsty is bad when you start playing yourself. That's when thirsty begins to be too bad. When you're too eager for the wrong stuff, that's when thirsty becomes bad. Look at somebody say water. Say water again. We can never have enough water. We need water. You know, you can live without food for a few weeks, I think it is. About 3 weeks, 3-4 weeks you can live without food. But you can only live a few days without water. The body needs water. A lot of this body that we have today is made up of what? Water. So what happens in the body is there becomes an imbalance of fluids. You need to have your fluids to function properly. The body needs water. One of the fundamental tendencies of the human body is whatever it takes out, whatever it puts out, it wants to get back. Whatever goes out, it wants to get back. For example, when you go to jogging, when you're running, when you're outside having a good time, you begin to sweat. You begin to get tired, right? That's because the body is putting out sodium, which is that salty taste in your sweat, and also water. So what does the brain do? It signals, I'm thirsty because I'm losing my fluids, the fluids that are there that's supposed to keep everything working normally and flowing properly, there's now an imbalance. And I told you all before, when you throw off the balance of something, you mess with the normal order of things. Amen? So what the body puts out, it wants to take back in. Think about it. Even when we get sick, not just from exercising or doing intense activity, even when we get sick. And that sickness makes us maybe have to go to the bathroom a lot. Sometimes it makes us bring stuff back up, regurgitation. When things like that happen, you are losing vital bodily fluids. So when you go to the hospital, what do? They put an IV in you to get your fluids back to normal. Amen? Okay, so we understand how this really works. The brain signals, I'm thirsty. And one of your first reactions when you get thirsty is to quench the thirst. We want to quench it, right? We want to quench the thirst. Well, what does quench really mean? Quench means to satisfy or put out, as in flame. Don't be out here looking thirsty. Don't be out here too thirsty. So when you get thirsty, one of the first things you want to do as a human, as a mammal, you want to drink. So be careful what you're thirsty for, because you may end up satisfying the wrong things. Young people, you got to be careful. Think about it now. If you get thirsty for cigarettes, you're going to have to satisfy that urge to smoke. If you get thirsty on drugs, you're going to have to satisfy or quench that desire to do drugs. If you get hooked on alcohol, this stuff is not a plaything. It's not a toy. This is not a game. If you get hooked, you are going to have to satisfy those urges to drink more and more and more. If you get hooked, if you get too thirsty for fighting, it's not just food, it's not just liquid. If you get thirsty for drama, Ryan, you're going to have to satisfy those urges. I know people who aren't, they don't feel like they're significant unless they're stirring up some kind of drama. That's because they're thirsty for the wrong stuff. And when you're thirsty for the wrong things, you're going to have to satisfy those things some kind of way. That's why we tell you to keep your environment conducive for the Holy Spirit to deal with you on a daily basis. If your environment is not set up for the Holy Spirit to help you, you are in a world of trouble, because now you're out there on your own and you're thirsty, and you might lose your gift, you might lose your blessing. So this is why we tell you, young people, don't do, stay away from, avoid, don't watch those type of shows. My boys, they know if they play a YouTube clip and I hear any F-bombs, S-bombs, D-bombs, or any other kind of bombs, I'm taking Wi-Fi, I'm taking the iPad, I'm taking everything. Don't play that stuff in my house. I don't want it in your system, because you might get thirsty for it. I know every one of us in here, we know somebody just cuss all the time. They feel like their sentence isn't fulfilled unless they put a cuss word in it. So your vocabulary becomes thirsty for profanity. Come on, somebody. Think about, and we just introduced our Snapchat page for the young people. I don't want to see no cussing on there. I don't want to see no nude selfies on there. Come on, old people, say something. See, y'all get too quiet. Our Snapchat page is going to be about Splash Club and doing good things and big things and rewarding people and building people up, not to tear people down. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to block you, and then I'm going to have a meeting with you in my office, and it ain't going to be pretty. Ain't going to be no glow sticks around my neck when you're sitting in my office, I promise you. You got to be serious about these things. We want you to have fun. We want you to do your thing. We want you to have your swag, but you're going to do it the right way. All right. Do it the right way. So you think about it. You see all on social media. What do we see? All these selfies. You can get thirsty for yourself. Just thirsty. You got your phone, Ryan. Where your phone? I saw you on it. Get here, boy. Y'all know how we do. What this mean right here when the ladies poke out their lips? What that mean? Do the lip thing make you look better? Come on, Dre, tell me what that mean, man. ain't saying, I'm thinking you about to say something. Give me a scripture or something. What does that mean? Here you go, boy. Here. Don't be out here being too thirsty. Think about a vehicle. Think about a car. When you in order for the car to run and function properly, what does it need? Well, the engine needs gas, right? Needs oil. It needs transmission fluid in order for the gears to work. In order for the brakes to work, it needs brake fluid, right? Needs all of these things. Well, what happens if it doesn't have enough gas? Stops. What happens if you don't put that oil in that car right at the right time? What happens? The engine will blow. It's going to cost you thousands of dollars. The car will eventually stop. What happens if you run out of brake fluid? What, you're not going to be able to stop, so it may cause you to have an accident. Things don't work properly when you get too thirsty. You need to keep the balance on point, so you don't have a moment where you're not functioning properly. So we think about that spiritually. You may be in spiritual imbalance. You ever stop to think, why are things just going wrong for me? Why everything I touch, nothing seems to manifest, nothing seems to come my way? I don't ever get the promotion. I don't ever get the goodies from God. Well, you might be in spiritual imbalance. Some things may be out of sorts. Well, what are you talking about, Pastor Jay? Well, you used to pray all the time. Now you don't pray at all. Used to come to church. We used to see you right there in your seat every day. Now look at it. It's empty. Where are you? What's taking up your time? What's taking up all of your spiritual energy? Amen? Amen. You may be at a place where you stop giving. You're in a season of drought because God has closed up the heavens on you because you stopped giving towards his ministry. All of these things are important to keep your spiritual balance. Come on, somebody, make some noise. We talked about it one of the first weeks we started. Relationship requires responsibility. You're going to have to do something in order to stay in the good graces. You're going to have to do your part in order to sustain the divine relationship. But don't be out here being thirsty. Ooh-wee. How do we prevent thirstiness? How do we prevent it? I always have to, as the leader, have to tell you your ways of prevention, your options. Three things. Young people, say three things. Young people, say it louder. Y'all louder than that. Say three things. That's right. That's right. Talk back to me. It's y'all day. Say lapse. Lapse. That's right. I want you to do your lapse. What does lapse stand for? I want you to listen, adjust, and progress. Listen, adjust, and progress. Say it with me. Listen. Adjust. What's your problem, boy? Listen. Adjust. And progress. First thing we want to teach here at Living Waters Church is to follow instructions. If somebody in authority tells you to do something, repeat something, go somewhere, you do what you're asked to do. We're always going to be on our best behavior here at Living Waters Church. Amen? Amen? All right, all right. Pastor ain't mad at you. I just want y'all to understand how we do things around here. So we must do our laps. Think about it when you're on the basketball team, when you're on the baseball team, when you're on the football team. First thing coach tell you to do when you get there, get them laps. Right? Get them laps in. What does those laps make you do? It gets you conditioned. Gets your stamina up. So you got to do your laps. You got to listen to people. Make the proper adjustments when you get the valuable information, and then you have to progress. You have to go and start moving towards becoming a better you. Somebody say, do your laps. Do your laps. If you ever get into any kind of situation and you come to see Pastor Mel or myself, whether it's marriage counseling, whether it's a disciplinary action in school, whether you just have it, you're in a bad place, you're in a bad season, first thing Pastor Mel and I are going to ask you, have you been doing your laps? Have you been doing your laps? See, you can't just come in my office and drop stuff on me and you haven't been doing your part. I'm going to expose that. Just the way I want y'all to keep me accountable, I want to keep y'all accountable. We got to do what we're supposed to do. So when we go to the throne of grace on your behalf, God is going to hear us. He's going to answer us. But not if you ain't doing what you're supposed to do. This is not a free-for-all. Salvation is free, but you're going to have to do your part. I'm sorry. Did I scare the baby? My bad. I'm sorry. He like, that too loud, Pastor. That too loud. I'm sorry. God wants all of us, old and young, not just the young people, but all of us to obey his commandments. But for the children, he focused everything on obeying your parents. All the parents should have been screaming and hollering. Y'all too quiet at Living Waters this morning. I said, for the children, the objective is to obey your parents. That's what I'm talking about. You hear Walter back there, yes, sir, Doc. Where my young people at? Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. I see you. How many of my young people in here under the sound of my voice right now want to please God? Show me by clapping your hands. All right. Well, if you want to please God, James, put it up there. Colossians 3 and 20. Not 21 yet. 3 and 20. 3 and 20. If you want to please God, watch what the Word of God says. It says, children, do what your parents tell you to do. This delights the master to no end. I'll read it again if they don't have it up there. Children, do what your parents tell you to do. This makes God smile. Y'all just told me. You basically made a promise to me. You said, I want to please God, right? What makes God smile is you listening to your parents. That's the Bible. How many of you want to do well? Show me your hand. Show me your hand. Show me your hand. Young people now. I'm really talking to my young people. Look at that. Older people like, ooh, that's me. That's me, Pastor. This ain't for you today. This is for my babies. This is for my babies. Well, I always like to back things up with the Word of God because this is our life playbook, right? This is what we go by. This is how we learn, okay? Now, in Ephesians 6 and 1, watch what it says. If they don't have it on the screen, I'll read it for you. Children, do what your parents tell you. This is only right. Honor your father and your mother is the first commandment that has a promise attached to it. Namely, so you will live well and live a long time. That's the Word of God. It don't need no help. That's what the book says. If you do what I tell you to do while I'm trying to teach you, if you do what your mom tells you to do while she's trying to teach you, it's the commandment. If you honor us, the commandment says there's a promise attached to it. You do those things, you'll live good, and you'll live a long time. You'll be able to live and move into the house you want to move into. You'll be able to live and do the things that you want to do. Y'all know them nice whips we want to drive, the Bugattis and the Lamborghinis and the Bentleys and the Roses and the Phantoms and the Ghosts. Y'all know that stuff. If you want it, do right by your parents. And it's not all about just material things, but those are some perks that can help you motivate you, right? Them some perks that I like. Sometimes Mama Essie will call me just going off. Going off. I'm your mother, boy. I ain't heard from you in 3 days. What's your problem? You ain't called me. God ain't gonna bless you because you ain't called your mama. But mom, I was on the shut-in. I was praying. I don't care nothing about that. You call your mama. But mom, oh, you talking back? You talking back to your mama? She 80 and something. Now, I ain't gonna pretty much do nothing, but she's just bad. She's just bad, right? I love my mama. But whenever I get or think that I'm about to get frustrated with something that my mom's disciplining me at, I start to think about the word of God. It says to honor your mother and your father. That ain't no choice that I have. I gotta do that. If I want to be blessed, I gotta look out for Mama Essie. I gotta do right by Mama Irma. I gotta do right by my mother and my father. Even your spiritual leaders. Am I the spiritual daddy? Y'all gotta do right by me if you want your spiritual life to be intact. That's the word of God. Ain't enough people clap. I don't know what to feel about that. Come on, y'all. Y'all got to work with me here. Work with me. Young people, when bad people come to tempt you, when bad people come to tempt you, the first thing I want you to do is identify them. How do you identify bad people? The Bible tells us by the fruit that they bear. If somebody always coming to you with drama, gossip, and rumors, you know that that's just about not a good person. So you all have to be attentive. Y'all got to look out for each other. If somebody comes to you and all they want to do is talk about people, that's probably not the person you want to hang around. Because guess what? As soon as you turn your back, guess who they talking about? Fake, shady people. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that in the mic. Proverbs 1:8. Watch this. Pay close attention, friend, to what your father tells you. Never forget what you learn by those quality moments you spend with your mother. Wear their counsel like flowers in your hair, my little ladies, like rings on your finger. Dear friend, if bad companions tempt you, don't go along with them. If they say, let's go raise some havoc, if they say, let's beat up some old man, if they say, let's go beat that girl down, if they say, let's go kick that little boy over there, you are supposed to stay away from them. Don't give them a second look, is what the Bible says. Don't listen to them for a minute. They're racing to a very bad end, hurrying to ruin everything they lay their hands on. Everything they lay their hands on. So, Ryan, if you got that bad spirit in you and I come up to you and give you a pound, you've just transferred all that badness up in me. That's why you got to be careful about the company you keep. That's why you got to be careful about the people that you let in your space. Everybody can't get all up in here. Everybody can't wrap their arms all up around me. I don't like your spirit. You ain't coming from the right place. I'm trying to do some things in the kingdom. And I can't be fooling around here with you while you transferring that stuff all into me. I'm about Jesus' business up in here. And you got to get to the point to where you don't care what people think about you. Don't nobody in here have the keys to heaven to put me in or take me out. Nobody in here. So I got to try to please God. Got to do right by what God says. Amen? Amen? Come on, somebody give God praise again. Oh, I got a good one. I think Jamel over there followed me. Let's go to Exodus 21:15, if you got it back there. Watch this one. This one's a good one. Let me tell you something. You can't be flaring up and poking your chest all out and getting all huffy and puffy with your mom and daddy. Can't do it. Word of God says you can't do it. This is how they did it in the Old Testament. Watch this, PDA. Exodus 21 says, if someone hits his father or mother, shame on you. If somebody hits, this is what it says in the message. It says, if someone hits their father or mother, the penalty is death. Good God Almighty. Thank God for Jesus' saving grace. I would have never hit my dad anyway because he probably took me out. But I'm just saying, the law was strict. That's the value that they have on parents. You just can't walk in your living room and tell your mama or your daddy what you ain't gonna do. You can't be walking around here talking about, well, who you think you are? I'm your mother. I'm your father. And the Bible says you are to honor and obey me. Unflare yourself. Calm down. Sit down somewhere because you might find yourself in a bad situation, player. Fathers, Dre, Joe, Blackburn, soon to be. D-Dub, soon to be. Daddies, don't let your kids come up to you and punk you. I know it. John can bleep that out the tape. We'll be good. We all at home right here. Let your kids punk you. They don't run your house. You run your house. Get control back over your stuff. Doing all you can for them, providing for them, lights, cameras, action, Wi-Fi, internet, PlayStation, YouTube, everything. And you think you're going to walk up to me, talk about who you think I am? Well, give me all my stuff back, Doc. Let me get them shoes up out you, player. Let me get that TV. Let me get that basketball team. Let me get that jacket. Let me get that Rice Krispies. Let me get that Captain Crunch. Give me that back up out you, boy. Let me get that up out you. We used to say back in our day, check it in, player. What they say now, PDA, run that. Run that. That's what the Bible say. We got to get control back of our kids because we love you. We know what we're doing. We didn't just pop up on the earth at 40, 50 years old, 60 years old. We didn't just pop up here. We didn't just appear. We did all the same stuff you're doing. We told untruths. We forged grades. Yep. We did it all. Y'all not doing nothing we ain't ever done before. So when y'all try to run that on us, it don't work because we didn't seen it before, Benjamin. Come on, boy, that ain't going to work. In the morning, Melanie walk in the room. They talking about, get up. You're going to school. She don't even be playing. Boy, bye. Boy, bye. I ain't playing with you. I'm leaving in 7 minutes. You better have your hind parts downstairs. Because we done done it before. We know the real cough versus the, come on, boy. Stop it. The Bible says you can't have your way all the time. Can't just be about you. 1 John 2:15. 1 John 2:15. 1 John 2:15. It says, don't love the world's ways. Don't love what everybody else is doing. Now, this ain't the greatest example, but I'm going to just use it for lack of thinking of another one. Just because everybody else doing the mannequin challenge don't mean you have to. The mannequin challenge ain't bad. I'm just using that. We're so quick to just jump on board with anything. Some of it's fun. Some of it's cool. But then other stuff just be like, okay, what are we doing? Well, that's what just everybody else doing. So I just did mine. Did you ever stop to think that if it was smart or not? Did you need to do it or not? They had this thing, not to this phenomenon that came on the scene, Pokemon Go. Even grown people out in the middle of the night talk about Pokemon. Pokemon. There's nothing there. Pokemon. People were getting hit by cars, run over because they chasing Pokemon. Come on, Tracy, at some point you got to start to think, is this smart what I'm doing here? at 3 o'clock in the morning out here chasing something that's on a game that's not even here on earth? But just because everybody else doing it, we doing it. What's the Bible say? Don't love the world's ways. Don't love the world's good. The love of the world squeezes out the love of the Father. Love of the world squeezes out the love of the Father. When you got too much worldliness in you, you don't have no room for godliness. Somebody should have made a little bit more noise than that, right? When you got too much stuff in you, you ain't got enough spirit in you. Your temple is too cluttered. Holy Spirit has no room to take up residence because you got it full of other stuff, full of other junk, full of drama, full of bad habits, full of bad thoughts. The Holy Spirit cannot operate in such an environment. Watch this. Practically, come on, Greeny, practically everything that goes on in the world, wanting, what does it say? Wanting everything for yourself, wanting to appear important. Bruh, Nick, Tracy in my seat, can you tell her to move down? It's 1,100 seats in here. Who named that seat your seat? That's because you got too much junk in you. You want to be important. Sit somewhere else and enjoy Jesus. I know, y'all. This is getting out of hand, right? The world and all its wanting is on its way out. But whoever does what God wants is set for eternity. That's what the Bible says. Come on, let's give some. So we want to make sure we honor our leaders. We talked about that. Not just mom and dad. We want to honor our spiritual leaders. Elder Joe ain't just walking through the halls, young people, telling y'all what to do because he's an elder. He's been sanctioned by God. He's been ordained. He knows a little bit. He knows a little bit more than what you know. So you got to pay attention to that. Pastor Mel, myself, Mother Moss, all the Pastor P, Minister Keisha, all these ministers, these men and women of God here. We're in these positions for a reason. It says be responsive to your pastoral leaders. Listen to their counsel. They are alert to the condition of your lives and work under the strict supervision of God. So as I'm leading you, God's leading me. So when I tell you something, God already told me. So that's why you got to be subject to your spiritual leaders. What does it say? Contribute to the joy of their leadership, not its drudgery. Why would you want to make things harder for them? Parents, we got to do the work now. Proverbs 22 says, point your kids in the right direction when they are old, they won't be lost. Train up a child in the way that it should go. And when he's older, he won't depart from it. So if we do our work now, at Splash Day 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, we won't have so much trouble in the future. Amen? Everybody good? I just love the Word of God. It just preaches itself. You don't have to add no cliches to it. You don't have to do nothing with it. It just happens. It's just good all by right there on the paper by itself. I just love the Word of God. It's good for correction and reproof and instruction so that you can be equipped to do the work of God. Amen? All right, I'm finished. Stand up, everybody. Stand up. Now watch this. Watch this. Say this with me. Don't lose your gift. For out here being too thirsty. I'm sorry, my musicians messed with me right there. Say, don't lose your gift. For being too thirsty. We started off talking about Esau and Jacob. We read the scripture. Isaac and Rebekah, right? Isaac and Rebekah. they were due a son. God promised them that they would have some babies. And when Rebecca finally got pregnant, she was pregnant with twins. These twins were Esau and Jacob. These dudes were at it so much that even inside of their mother, she said, they're moving around so much. Is this how pregnancy's really supposed to go? Look at him. Look at my stomach. Is this jumping? What in the world? And the prophecy of the Lord came. The Lord spoke and he said, they're like two nations at war with each other. But the day will come where the older will have to serve the younger. This happened while they were still in the womb. The word of the Lord went forth while they were still young. They weren't even out here yet. So they came out. Of course, Esau came out first. Then we had Jacob. And they said when Jacob was born, he grabbed his brother's foot. He grabbed his foot. So the scholars put it together. They said after Esau would be over and finish, then the reign of his brother would take shape. So from the head to the toe, you grab toe. Once you get through with Esau's reign, then you go right into Jacob. But they didn't know all of this while this was happening. They didn't see it until much later. So as they go through their childhood, they're doing their thing. The daddy loved both of his children, but he really loved Esau because Esau was a hunter. He was strong. He would go out in the field and he would bring back food. All types of burgers and pizza and chips and candy and stuff. Esau, when he came in, you know it was time to eat. Come on, baby, heat up the oven. But Jacob was more the smart one. He hung around his mom. He knew how to fold clothes. He knew how to cook. Those are good skills to have. Woman ain't gonna always be around to cook. You better learn how to cook for yourself. Look at my wife. That's right. So, the daddy, Isaac, he loved both of the children, but he really loved Esau because he satisfied his belly. And then Jacob, he said, man, Isaac was well-to-do. He had stuff, Mom. So Isaac knew his inheritance was automatically going to Esau. That was the older brother. That was the law-dee-duh. That's how it worked. But Jacob really wanted it. Jacob always looked at his brother and was like, man, you don't care nothing about that inheritance. You ain't gonna even know what to do with that inheritance. You ain't even smart like that. You ain't gonna know what to do with all that money. You ain't gonna know what to do with all that land. Why should you get it? And one day, this is where the message is coming to a head. One day, Jacob caught Esau slipping. He caught him slipping. When did he catch him slipping? When he became too thirsty. He became too thirsty. He was out in the field. They say maybe it was for a few days, few weeks. We don't know. But he was out there and he came back home and he was like, I'm hungry. I'm hungry. Can somebody get me some food? What is that smell? Who's cooking that? Whatever it is, I want some of it. Jacob said, I got him. Got him. I'm about to get him. So what did he do? He came in there, man, and said, yo, give me a plate of that. Give me a piece of that pizza. Give me some of that stew. Right? And he says, I'll give it to you if you give me your inheritance. Now, Esau, at this moment, supposed to stop and say, boy, is you crazy? I just asked for some Cheerios. I ain't asked for nothing. What you mean my inheritance? But he called him thirsty. That's why you can't be out here too thirsty, because you'll mess around and let your thirst cheat you out of your inheritance. Your thirst will cheat you out of your blessing. Your thirst will cheat you out of what God has for you. He caught him slipping, baby. He caught him slipping. y'all saw the word of God. He said, I don't care nothing about that birthright. What good is it going to do me now? I don't need my father's inheritance. I'm a hunter. I'm skilled. I get mine right here. You see these guns? I'll take down a bear with my bare hands. This is who I am. I'm Esau. I'm hungry. Give me some food. Thirsty. Sat there, gave his birthright, gave his inheritance to his little brother. Lost his blessing. His mother was there, served as a witness. And as it pertains, as the word of the Lord was fulfilled, Jacob inherited everything. And the older had to serve the younger. Young people, I don't ever want you to be in a position to where you lose your gift, where you lose your blessing. I don't ever want you to be in that position. So under the sound of my voice, the ministers are coming. I want all of the young people up here on stage right now. Come on, move fast, move fast, move fast, move fast. We got to cover your life. Don't let it get quiet, musicians. Come on, we got to set this place up. I want to cover my young people. We're in a season we don't know where the government is headed. We don't know what's going on. We don't know what's walking up and down the hallways of our schools. We got kids out here being snatched off of the street, used for sex trafficking, drug trafficking, people trafficking. We gotta cover our babies. We gotta cover our babies. I want them all up here. 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 Not too loud, Ryan. Not too loud. Not too loud. I don't want them to understand. Come on, Minister Keisha. Minister Keisha, Minister Joe. Come on, we're going to get in front of them. Since they lined up that way, we're going to get in front of them. Y'all just take an in. Everybody take an in. Mom, where are you? Come on, Mom. Come on out to the front. Keisha, you take the far wing. Mom, you take right here. I'll take right here. Joe, you grab these. And we're going to go through the throne of grace. I want everybody in this room praying to cover our babies. Cover our babies. We ain't asking for nothing right now. We're not asking for cars and money and stuff. We are asking for the covering of our children. Cover their minds. Cover their bodies. Cover their intellect. Come on, somebody. Come on, as we go through the throne of grace right now. Father, it's in the name of Jesus. I bless these children. I want y'all to pray. Bow your head and pray with us. Oh, Jesus. God. Father, we stand on your word. We stand on your word. We stand on your word. I release the power that you vested in me. As one of your chosen, God, I release and I partner with these children, the anointing. And I share my anointing with them, God. God, in their decision making, I just share it with them, God. Allow them to make the right decision. Allow them to pick the right friends. Allow them to do the right things. Allow them to want to be better. Allow them to want to be better. Allow them to want to be better. I release it over their lives now. Let them know that serving you is not whack. Serving you is not corny. Serving you is not the hard thing to do. God, I shut you up. Hey, yeah. Hey, say her haji. Break her up. Shut up. God, we bless these young people. We cover them as they come and go. I drive back stray bullets. I drive back sexual perversion. I drive back sexual perversion. I drive back sexual perversion. I drive back all the need, the desire to want to fit in. I drive back the feeling of inferiority. I drive it back. These are our babies. And we love them. We love them. We love them. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Thank God. Everybody up on this stage, clap like you ain't never clapped before. Tell God you love him. Tell God you love him. Tell God you love him. Hallelujah. What I want you to do. What I want you to do. Every single day. Hold up, Ryan. Every single day, I want you all to partner with me. And I know you love your pastor. I want you to partner with me and carve out 5 minutes. 5 minutes. And Pastor P and Minister Key will help you develop this in the near future. But right now, I just want 5 minutes a day for you to read your Bible. Just five. You do 30 on Facebook. You do 30 on Snapchat. Partner with me. And moms and dads, I want y'all to do a check to make sure y'all encourage this type of behavior. Get some Bibles. Download. They got everything else on their phones. Download a Bible. It don't have to be the King James Version. It can be the Message Version. Whatever it is, I need them to get some word up in them. I want 5 minutes a day. That's all. Give me 5 minutes a day. And then you will see that things will start to work out for your lives. Things will start to get a lot better for you. Because you're doing what you're supposed to do and you're doing right by God. I love y'all. Y'all love me back? All right, you can go back to your seats rejoicing. Come on. Come on. Go back with a smile on your face. Go back with a smile on your face. Go back with a smile on your face.
Come on, come on, come on. Let's thank God for a wonderful word. Come on, let's thank God for a wonderful word over our children, over our future. Come on, let's thank him. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for a wonderful word. Give it back to him, we pray, in the name of Jesus. Give it back to him, we pray, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It's offering time in the building. Come on, it's offering time. Let's get excited for offering time. We know when we give, he'll give it back unto us, amen? Those of us here at LWC, we know that we have three ways to give. We give in person. We have a card swipe in the back that you can go to with your debit card and swipe your card. And also, we have online that you're able to e-give. We can give online, so sometimes we can take care of that even before we get to church, amen? Amen. And we believe in giving offerings, amen. Amen. Our Pastor Jay is starting this offering off with $200. Amen. 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 Those of you that have your offering, please stand. Please stand. Give and it shall be given unto you, pressed down, shaken together, running over. That's how God does, amen. And we don't give grudgingly, we give willingly. Cheerful, for the Lord loves a cheerful giver. A cheerful giver. We don't just say it out of ritual when it's time to give. We clap because we know as we give willingly, God will give back unto us, amen. Hallelujah. We're in the hands of the ushers as they come, and let us pray. Father, we thank you. We praise you. We give you glory and honor, O God, as we give, O God, unto you. We know that you will give it back unto us, O God. We ask that you will bless it, not only for this ministry, but for our personal lives, we pray, O God. And we thank you by faith in Jesus' mighty and precious name, we pray. Thank God. Amen and amen. Follow the ushers as they come.
This is Pastor P. Welcome to Splash Day.
Splash Day number one.
Welcome to Splash Day.
Welcome to Splash Day.
Splash Day.
Splash Day.
Welcome to Splash Day.
Number one.
Number one.
Number one.
Number one.
Number one.
You'll get to take over the church.
Splash Day one.
Day one.
Hello everyone. This year, team reporter Madison Kearney reporting for LWC TV. Today's our first annual Splash Day number one. Thank you so much for being here with us today. Remember to follow Living Waters Church on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and also on our website at lwcdetroit.com. And to add to our social media family, the Splash Club introduces LWC on Snapchat. Be sure to add us and join in all the fun. That's LWC Detroit on Snapchat.
Hey there everyone, this is Designy Brown, your Splash Teen reporter for LWC TV. Last week, Pastor Jay introduced the Living Waters Church phone line. The number is 313-296-1127. Please remember that if you call, to leave a detailed message stating your name, callback number, and a brief detailed description of the nature of your call, and someone will get back with you promptly. You can also leave a text message and the staff will respond via text. If you can't remember the number, you can always visit our website at lwcdetroit.com.
What's up? It's your boy Elijah Elam, your team reporter for LWC TV. And once again, welcome to Splash Club Day 1. After having an amazing breakout service today, I'm sure you've worked up quite a hearty appetite. So immediately after service, please support the LW Splash Club and stop by the hot dog stand on the way out. While you're there, grab hot dog, chips, and a drink for a nominal fee. Please help Splash Club as we do our part in expanding Living Waters Church. Thanks.
Greetings, everyone. I'm your Splash Teen reporter, Pastor Jay. And no, I'm not a teenager, but this is my church, so that makes it okay. I'm just kidding. What's up, y'all? Welcome to Splash Day number one. Make some noise in the building. Listen, I hope you're having a great time, but I have a special announcement to make. I'm really excited about May 14th. Save the date, May 14th. That's Mother's Day. And guess who we have coming to Living Waters Church? It's our very own minister, Keisha Allen. She'll be bringing the word of God on May 14th. And listen, let me tell you something. If you haven't heard this woman or experienced her anointing, you are in for a treat. Save the date, May 14th, 10:45, right here, Mother's Day, inside the Grand Theater, Cass Tech High School. Living Waters will experience the mighty woman of God, Minister Keisha Allen. We'll be talking more about it next week. But for now, let's continue to enjoy Splash Day number one. Yeah. Holla at your boy.
Splash Day.
Splash Day.
Splash Day.
Welcome to Splash Day.
Number one.
Number one.
Number one.
Number one.
Number one. You'll get to take over the church.
Splash Day one.
Day one.
Day one.
Day one.
Okay,
Look. CD. Show them some love, y'all. Thank y'all. We're good. Make sure we got one more piece. But I want to go ahead and get the particulars out of the way real quick before we do our last piece. I want y'all to see this. Give me the name again. Is this it right here? Any different? All right, we got a same one. Mr. Tim Grimmel? Grimmel. Mr. Tim Grimmel. He's a state representative. He's in our midst. There he is. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate you. Thanks so much. Hey, it's good when we got, you know, government officials in here. Looking out for us, y'all. I love it. I love it. Thank you. Please, you're welcome to come back anytime. We appreciate that. Splash Day number one. Listen, we have next week, we're getting back to our normal time, our normal services, right? 10:45 a.m. here. We're going to see you back. And then also the week after that, May 14th, is Mother's Day. We want to pack this place out. We want to do our mothers right. Amen. Then, of course, our very own Minister Keisha Allen will be bringing the powerful word of God. I need you to be here. I need you to help promote our Mother's Day service. I believe we're ready. Come on, Kyrie, give me a little smoke. Little Jamel, give me a little video. And I think we're ready to take this thing on home. Somebody make some noise for Splash Day number one.
Strange like I'm supposed to care. Yeah. Woo! You don't know my story or the cross to bear. Uh-huh. When they hold me down, it ain't even fair.
Still living my life.
No worse for the wear. These days, everybody want Hollywood. Little more Jesus, do your body good. Let the world know you're paying price for temptation, but there's no price for salvation.
Cause I love them like I
say you that I love
them. If you try me, you will love them.
You will love them too.
Cause I love them like I
say you that I love
them. If you try me, you will love them.
Come on, hey, ain't nobody.
DJ Root, DJ Root, DJ Root. Cut it up, girl. PDA, where you at? DJ Crew is in the building! Yeah, yeah, yeah! There she goes!
Mm-hmm.
Yeah! Come on, one more time for our own. These are our own, y'all! DJ Root, Splash Club, Splash Day number one. Huge success. I love our babies, don't you? Yes, awesome job. All of you that are visiting us here, thank you so much for coming. This is just how we do. We love our children. We want them to feel like they can express God their way. Amen? Big, huge shout out to the coordinators, the directors, the pastors of this department, Minister Pastor Paul D. Allen and Minister Keisha Allen. Come on, y'all. Show them some love. And, of course, our youth director in training, James L. Moss Jr. Come on, show him some love. He had to run. Any birthdays in May? What are we, in April? Any birthdays? We got one. We got a couple. Got a couple. Jay Moss. Oh, we got a few. Come on up here. Come on up here. Where my birthday's at? Come quick, quick, quick. Who, mama? Your mama? Your mama. We got birthdays. We got birthdays in April, y'all. Oh, bless their heart at birthdays. We just want to sing happy birthday to them, and then we're going to dismiss. There we go. There's Tam. Come on. Everybody together. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. My bad. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear all y'all. Happy birthday to Pastor Mel and I want to see you out in the lobby. Father God, we just ask that you come. We ask that you bless and take us to our designated places. God, we thank you for an excellent service. We thank you for allowing us to hollow out time for our children to express themselves. Now, God, watch over them. Cover their lives. Bless them as they come and they go. God, see them in their school. See them as they walk to school. See them as they walk home from school. God, be there for them. Cover their lives and tap them on the shoulder and let them know that you're walking with them every step of the way. Now, God, we'll always be careful to give your name the praise, the glory, and honor shall be thine. I'm asking for resources and increase for Living Waters Church. Bless every family represented here. Every family represented here. Every family represented here today. In Jesus' name, everybody said with a loud voice,